In this lesson, we are going to create the delete button and scaffold the delete action on the show screen. So let me open here the supplier show page. And on this supplier show page, I'm going to add a delete button. So I'm going to add some space here on the show record. So I'm going to add a row here, and I'm going to drag and drop a button into this row. Okay, and now I'm going to right click on this button and scaffold the delete action using this option here. This operation creates the action to delete the current record on the screen and changes this button accordingly. On the screen, we have a new screen action, delete supplier. This button here is linked to this action. We're going to see that further ahead, but let's first look into the delete action itself. And as you would expect, it deletes the supplier. It gives back a feedback message to the user, and it redirects the user to the supplier list screen. And on the button, as we discussed, so the button is linked to the delete supplier action, and there's a property here, a confirmation message that we haven't discussed yet. This property here sets a message that is displayed to the end user of the application so that the operation is confirmed before the record is deleted. So let's publish and see all this in action. Okay, so here we have our application. Let's go into one of these records, for instance, this one, and here we have our new delete button. And if we click the button, we have that confirmation message that I was talking about. So here, this operation can't be undone. Are you sure you want to delete the supplier? So it identifies the supplier that we are deleting and says, click OK to proceed. If we cancel, then the action is not executed. But if we confirm the operation, OK, then here we have our feedback message and the user is directed back to the supplier list screen. And that's it.